Welcome back to the studio. If you're new, I am Slew. So 2023 coming to an end. Good time to reflect on where I've come from, what I'm doing here at my studio, my full-time job managing the studio, being an artist, YouTuber, you know, starting in my garage way back in 2014, then painting in my room for a few years, then building and renovating this really sort of dilapidated space into my old studio, which was 4 years of amazing times, really turned me and built me into the artist and person I am today, and then leaving that studio to expand into this studio here in Brooklyn, New York City. A lot has gone down and there's been a lot of jobs that I've done, and so this video is sort of just a modge podge of some random jobs that I do that I don't really put into videos that I think are fun to talk about and see. So that's this video. I also dropped out of 3 universities, so you can trust me. In this box is 3D prints of my logo, Studio Slew. Shout out to Emily, who designed this font. She's an awesome typographer. I'll link her, all her stuff, if you wanna see her different fonts, but it's the same logo for my website. So I wanted to upgrade the studio and how people find my studio with new signs. So these prints are hot off the press. I have some maintenance to do for them, like pull this junk off the back. I'm gonna sand it maybe a little, then I'm gonna spray paint it and attach it to another board. But it's really sexy and I'm really amped. This is just like another, you know, sort of unnecessary upgrade that I won't, and I'm going the extra mile. Actually made 2. You can see here pointing to the correct hallway. I live in this giant, my studio is in this giant building with 4 floors, and these hallways are massive with multiple tenants. So I wanted a place to have clear signs because not everyone knows exactly where I am. So right off the elevator, you get pointed to this one. So I made 2. Studio Slew. Go all the way down this hallway, then you take a left, and I think they look great. I'm actually really happy with them. Same colors as the website, same font, really awesome 3D prints. So just some minor customization here to ease the soul. We got prints. Now, this is an amazing thing to complain about because prints are awesome, selling your work to a lot of people, international. People all over the world buying your artwork is amazing, but the whole process and logistics behind, you know, setting up a website, taking payment, manufacturing prints, shipping out, dealing with international shipping, customer service emails, everything in between, it's really hectic, and any artist or anyone selling merchandise can tell you it's kind of a nightmare sometimes. But it's hard to complain is what I'm saying, as well as unboxing this big box filled with me artwork. We're gonna reuse this box, so I need to save it. Super professional printing and packing here. Wow. So we're gonna pack and sign individual ones. I think this is 30 of each. So we'll be organized here. That unboxing experience is quite satisfying. Nice, they look great. Fun fact, actually, I've only recently started selling prints. I sold hoodies and t-shirts way before I started selling actually nice prints. These are G-Clay prints, which basically means the process and the ink, super high quality, paper super nice, but it's only been like a few years because, again, the merchandising, logistics pipeline is kind of not always worth the money sometimes. You have to think, what is the function of this? Do I want people to have my art and enjoy my art and hang my art on their wall or get tattoos of my art? Obviously, but a large chunk of the pie chart agenda of my work is to make money because I have to pay rent, I have to pay for my life, and life is expensive. But sometimes this whole process isn't worth the money. You gotta spend a lot of money to make them, then you have to sell them. Okay, so I'm gonna lay these out, do a factory line of signing and numbering them. You know, that's kind of a lot, but as long as you're organized, stay clean, it should be lickety-split, and then I'll ship these off to the fulfillment center that actually ships these all around the world for me. So that was probably the most enjoyable part of this entire process, was touching all these babies and signing them. So that's definitely by far the most enjoyable part, is signing these puppies. Also, I'm pretty OCD about packing, so it's pretty satisfying how they packed it and repacking it so that it's safe, again, to go to the fulfillment center that ships them out individually, because I do not have the infrastructure or time to do it myself. Something similar to this that is a mega satisfying, still a job, but similar in the satisfaction rate, is actually varnishing paintings. But before we varnish, we need to talk about the sponsor of today's video, Skillshare. Skillshare is the world's largest learning community, ranging from all sorts of disciplines like illustration, watercolor, photography, music, marketing, other entrepreneurial skills, and everything sort of in between. I personally have acquired a lot of different skills, managing all the things I do and the work that I do. And I am where I am today because of resources like Skillshare that help you truly internalize these hobbies, turn them into passions, and really progress you into the new skills that they require. Skillshare's classes are taught by leading professionals in each discipline, which I think is just really awesome. There's a great class by Mike Vardy that I think everyone can benefit from, especially up and coming artists, rather than just progressing their individual crafts. This class is called Productivity Habits That Stick, and I think anyone from industry professionals to just the hobbyist can benefit from this sort of information and skill set on productivity. And that's sort of why I love Skillshare, and what makes it the best online learning community is that there's no requirements. Anyone from super mega professional to just starting out, getting your foot in the door, can take these classes. There's no prerequisites. It's for everyone. Skillshare, longtime sponsor, but also because I've actually used them and benefit. The first 500 people who click the link in the description will get a 1 month free trial of Skillshare. Really awesome. Booyah. Time to varnish. So varnishing, a very wonderful, but also sort of time consuming, stressful thing. You have to wait for oil paintings to dry for many months, upwards of 8 months. I usually do it around 6 months. This is the varnish I'm using. Also, it's satin in between gloss and matte, but you know, oil paint dries, the chroma leaves, the shadows lighten. So we varnish to bring back all that contrast and color, but also to protect the painting. It's like a protective layer, and it's really fun and it's really satisfying. I'm sure you've seen a million videos. It like brings paintings back to life. It's like the magical elixir. But it's annoying because you paint a lot and then you forget about paintings, and then you have to go through and varnish them, and sometimes there gets hairs stuck in them and you want them to be really pretty. It's like the final step, and it's 6 months later, and if it's a super big project that you worked really hard on, you know, it could just be a little pressure. Like this painting right here, this elf archway. You know, I don't think I go as crazy and bananas as some people, and there's a million ways to do it, and there's also a million videos, but yeah, varnishing is pretty great, but it's just a weird job. And half of my job also, non sequitur here, is constantly filming. So even though I was trying to capture all of this varnishing on my big camera, I had to do some short form and hold my phone while I was doing this delicate, important step. But that is life as a YouTuber, and life as, you know, someone who wants to document and share everything. That's what you gotta do, is film everything. So a lot of my life, I am looking through reality through a camera lens, and sometimes it's my phone. And it's pretty annoying, to be honest, the fact that there's short form and now you know, horizontal, vertical, it's pretty much the bane of my existence. But again, hard to complain. Did it to myself, the life I live, and I love sharing things. So it's always fun at the end of the day. It's just sometimes multitasking to the nth degree. This is one of my favorite paintings I think I've ever done, actually. I don't know if many people saw the video. I'll link it if you're interested, but love this hand sword. Similar to all of the hoodies I did, just sort of like very iconographic in my canon of work. Love it. And of course, we did get a up close. It's funny, I don't think I even posted these short form clips that I filmed with my iPhone, so really wasn't useful other than right now. I did this a few months ago, but yeah, varnishing. Let me know your experience down in the comments. What you think about varnishing, specifically with oil painting. I know acrylic, you don't have to as much. It's sort of different chemically.
Something I don't think people realize, and why would I show it, because it's not beautiful or glamorous, is how much I am cleaning and organizing this space. So as a manager of this studio, hosting a bunch of drawing sessions, doing huge projects constantly involving people, moving around stuff in the big space, getting new equipment, you know, there's always things that I need to clean and organize, and it's just madness. And it's something that I've come to enjoy because I am sort of like an OCD particular person, and I like things how I want them organized or set up in a certain way, but it's just shocking how much I'm really cleaning and organizing the space to just make it presentable but also efficient.
More studio maintenance you never really think of with the studio. These seamless backdrops, I use white the most, and when people stand here, it gets nice and dirty. And so then every once in a while, you could use it for quite a long time, but every once in a while, you could just cut it off and get some new crisp white down for new photo shoots, or if other friends or small businesses want the new fresh stuff, I do that. But eventually it runs out. And so now we need to replace it. This is easy to just throw out, but this mechanism, which I'll try to show you, is super easy because we just have two of these things which attach to the framing up there. And so we just pull them out, get rid of this tube and this paper, and put a new one up.
This indeed just arrived.
Ooh, look at that. Whoa. Also, just to confirm, this backdrop is 86 inches. So the sort of setup of rails is a little longer than that, but these are 86 inch pieces of paper. I think it's like 30 feet when it's unrolled. So also, if you've never seen this stuff, I wanna show you, maybe you could hear it. Like, this is not thin paper, it's very thick. You know, almost like a mixed media paper, and that helps obviously keep it wrinkle free, but also it's just more durable. Cutting off all these little pieces of tape. We just put this back right here. We tighten it up so it expands inside the tube. We're gonna do that to the other side. That is nice and taut. Don't try this at home. I just wanna get it up there first so I don't die. And then I can slot it in. There's like just little slots that it perfectly rests in. Wow, I almost nailed it actually. Whoa. Boom, and boom, we're in. I also like to grab a few of these clamps to put on the paper so that it gets weighted, so it will actually flop down, and then over time, gravity and just the weight will help that. But again, because the paper's so thick and it's been curled up so long in its packaging, it doesn't like to come down, doesn't like to roll down without weight. So now there's some weight. And that's a fresh new backdrop. Easy as pie. But I generally like to keep it up for a few reasons, because it stays cleaner that way. People don't step on it. But also, we got my mural here. And it's hidden when the backdrop is down. So seamless backdrop, super useful. Product photography, paintings. It's really not an expensive setup. Matter of fact, it's like the cheapest setup.
and I've had it for over 6 years now. Works amazing. Super professional also. That's it for this video. If you stayed to the end, comment happy 2023. Give yourself a pat on the back for surviving another year in this crazy world. Thank you so much for watching my videos. I hope you guys are constantly doing projects and being perhaps 1% inspired by these videos to go do some stuff on your own with this squeaky floor. I got 2 more drawing sessions tomorrow night and then Wednesday night. And then I'm off for like 2 weeks. I'm gonna go home to Connecticut, hang with my family, maybe see my aunt and uncle in Florida, and just reset for the new year. I love the reset. I think it's very cliche. I don't know if I already mentioned this in this video, but any excuse to like get a blank slate, reset your mind, reset goals, re-narrow your vision of what you actually like to do and the things you actually want to spend your time on, I'm all for it. So obviously December into January is a great and easy one to make that excuse, but for a good reason. Squeak. See ya in the new year.